Episode 1, The Phantom Menace. Chapter 2, Invasion of Naboo. The Trade Federation has launched a full-scale attack on the peaceful world of Naboo. Hiding aboard the landing craft, Qui-Gon Jinn and Obi-Wan Kenobi have secretly hitched a ride with the invasion force. Now, they must make contact with the local forces before it is too late. Bit of a lag there. Hopefully it doesn't show up too bad on the recording. This is the PC version of LEGO Star Wars Complete Saga, so sometimes my ports back then for LEGO games weren't always the best. I'm not sure if they've improved or not, because I've kind of stuck to console for a lot of my LEGO experience. What's wrong, man? So yeah, now we're on the surface of Naboo, and we have to now head off the invasion. Since negotiations did not go so well. Not really sure who would blame for that. I don't think they really wanted to negotiate in the first place by the sounds of it. So fortunately all these droids and stuff, they don't really target you. Except for like some scripted situations like this one. For the most part, you're pretty much able to just walk through. No problem. I don't know how worth it these flowers are, but I also don't know what the level... how many studs I need for completion is either. But for now, we'll just kind of collect what I can. I don't think I can do this one yet, because I think I need... Yeah, I need a blaster for that. And I don't think you get a blaster in this until way later. So, unfortunately, we'll just ignore that for now. Oh, watch out. Coming through. Get you. Okay. Get this tree out of the way here. Perfect. Nice and easy. So yeah, as a kid, I didn't really... A lot of people, like, grew up with, always talk about how they grew up with, like, LEGO Island, or, some of the much, much older LEGO games, Rock Raiders, or Racers. I've actually never really played those. I had LEGO Creator as a kid, and I also had LEGO Stunt Rally, and those were both really fun. But that was about it. I didn't really play LEGO games until Star Wars came out on GameCube. And obviously, it was the cool thing to do at the time was to make collectathon platformers, so definitely fit within my interests back then. Oh, I just lost that blue stud. That's not good. Basically have to start over from zero now. You can get to a point... I don't know if I can get this one, actually. I think I need an ability, which I do not have yet. Yeah, doesn't look like I can get up here. That's okay. So, LEGO Star Wars, the original 2, I would say, both had some notorious difficulty to them. You can die a lot, and if you die enough, you actually can get to a point where it's impossible to get the meter for that stage. Or if you like miss studs like this, I should be fine, even though I just missed all these ones. But there's some stages where you need to make sure you collect everything and don't die. Otherwise, you will have to start the level over if you want Jedi. Jeez, oh gosh, I just need to try and get these flowers because I want to... Don't want to lose every opportunity I can. There's one level in episode 3, I think it's the Battle of Kashyyyk. I can't remember which one it is exactly, but that level took me like 10 tries to try and do it normally, and you just can't. It wasn't until I ended up getting the invincibility power brick where I was able to actually beat that level and get the True Jedi meter. LEGO Star Wars 1, if I remember correctly, didn't actually have two separate meters for both story and free play. Only LEGO Star Wars 2 did. And I'm pretty sure this game does it as well. So that's why I need to make sure I don't miss anything. Oh, everyone's favorite character. You'll be happy to know that that's about all the speaking Jar Jar does in this. if you're one of those people. I personally never minded him too much. I didn't think he was that bad. But he's actually extremely useful, at least in story mode on this stage, and you'll see in a second here once we get past this room, because I just want to get out of here before any more droids attack. I don't think... You know what? We'll try that with his ability right now, actually. So, he doesn't do anything special, except he has an extremely high double jump. That's his ability. I don't know if I can get this from here. I think... I actually don't remember if you need something special to get that. Because there's no platforms around here. I'm not seeing anything else. I'm definitely pretty sure Jar Jar is required for it. There's other characters later on that have the same ability, but Jar Jar is the first one you get, and the most reliable when it comes to that said ability. Oh, here we go. They need that. So yeah, that's like a rule of thumb with LEGO games. If you don't know what to do, break everything. Use everything, because you never know where you'll find some key items like that platform. So obviously I'm not going to stay as Jar Jar because he has no attacking power. It's definitely better to stick to the Jedi for that. Alright, let's see here. That's going to create a bridge? Yeah. Okay. Oh shit. That was a really good shot. Holy shit. Imagine if they had that kind of aim in the movies. Yeah, so I'll release that. And I think I need to do the same thing over here. Oh, whoa. Frame lag, please. I don't think that's actually going to show up. It's really weird why it does that. I'm definitely going to try and use him for platforming just because he has the higher jump. Okay, so here's another type of door switch we need a bounty hunter for, and we won't be getting them until much, much later, so that's definitely not happening right now. Whoa! Hi there, droid. You too. Oh, shoot. Yeah, I definitely don't want to fall down the pit, because that's instant death, and you won't be getting any of the studs back after that. Okay, what's this going to do? Can I get up there? I should be able to. Yeah, yeah. Easy. Easy minikit. Oh. I probably can make that jump as a Jedi, but I'm not going to bother. Okay, good. So you can kind of like hold the attack button to do a block, but it doesn't actually deflect the blaster shots properly. You still have to do the timed hit to do that. Alright, so I'm about halfway to Jedi. Hopefully I haven't missed too many. Man. If I wasn't going for Jedi, I would definitely try for that, because that's like a really easy one, but I'm not going to do it. If I can get True Jedi and come back, maybe I will. Or, you know what? Never mind. Forget anything I said, because you can just do that. There are some minikits that are like really hard to get, and they have like really risky platforming that I want to try not to risk if I can help it. Right, give me health, give me health, give me that heart. Okay, good. No! Oh shit, okay, that's okay. Should be okay. But, I'm glad that I was wrong about that one. Now, if you look at this shiny portion here, we need thermal detonators to do that. I'm pretty sure this is one of those thermal detonator spots, because you can kind of see a room back there. So that's another use for bounty hunters that we will have to worry about later. Now, what's that gonna do? Okay. Whoa, game please. Yeah, I don't know, I think it's just this port of LEGO Star Wars that's kind of shit. Unfortunately. Okay, yeah, I want to try not to die. You can gather all your... Unlike Sonic, you only can lose a maximum of 4,000 studs. And you can collect them all back as long as they're on the stage. But it's just better to not die if you can help it. Oh, wow. I didn't realize this power-up had such a long range for grabbing. That's nice. Does it increase force speed? Oh, can't really tell. Well, another mini kit down, so that's good. I'll definitely take that. I want to say it's like 40,000 for this. LEGO Star Wars 1 had some really low requirements for the meter. It wasn't until LEGO Star Wars 2 that you needed like 100,000. OK, Okay, I think I need to go through there, so I'm gonna try and see if I can use Jar Jar to get up here. Yeah, should be able to. Perfect. Because there's some blue studs. I definitely don't want to try ignore blue studs, because they're worth 1,000 each. Oh, I guess I need to do that anyway, so that works out. But yeah, you have each one has different values. So you have white studs, which are 10, gold are 100, blues 1,000, and very rarely there's purple studs, and they're worth 10,000. So those are very helpful. I don't remember how far away we are exactly from the end of the stage, but I think we're kind of coming up to it, so I need to be careful to try and gather all the studs I can, so I can make sure I get the meter. Let's see, what are we building here? Oh, I see what we're building. So I have to do everything in the right order. This is a very common puzzle, is force stacking objects in the right order. Oh shit. Unfortunately, the AI partners in the early LEGO Star Wars games, they actually do zero damage. It wasn't until much later LEGO games that let partners actually do damage to enemies. So that also adds to the difficulty. There we go, another Minikit down. Wow, already half of them on this stage. I don't think there's any stage that lets you get all 10 in story mode, but you can get close on some of them. Thank goodness they're dropping these hearts so fast. Sometimes the hearts are like really rare, sometimes they're really common, so definitely happy that they're common this time. Alright, let's see here. Jeez, oh, yeah, and also getting hit destroys your focus, so you need to make sure there's no enemies around if you want to do anything force-related. Wish I didn't go flying everywhere. Well, that wasn't very much. I'm definitely thinking it's 40,000. It's usually some fairly round number. Okay, good. Oh, shoot, that's not good, though. Grab that heart. I won't go too far forward in case that's like the end. But I'm pretty sure there's at least one more scene. Or actually, you know what? That might be the end of the stage coming up there, so I need to. Yeah, so definitely want to. I think I'm going to move forward now because I've gotten everything I can. Oh, shoot. That's 4,000. 2, 4. Okay, good. Okay, good. Nice. Ooh, that worked out really well. Okay, there's another. Yeah, this is the end. Damn it. You know what? We're going to try going back. Let's see if I missed anything. Just to make sure. Because this is what I was talking about. You know, sometimes you'll get to a point where you just can't get anything else because you missed some. There's one over here I didn't hit. Definitely think I'm gonna go back because I'm like really close. I feel like there's something I could get that'll let me get enough. See how far back I can go. Can I break these? Maybe I can break these. Usually stuff that looks like Lego lets you break it, but not this time. I'm desperate, so I'm going to collect that one. Oh boy. This is the fun part of the LEGO games. Trying to backtrack, looking for studs. I'll collect this gold one. Oh man. I'm worried I can't go all the way back to the start. Oh, can I hit that? Does that do anything? Ooh! Oh, yes! Wow, that was good. Okay. That was quite a few studs I missed. Glad I picked it up. Oh, man. Is there anything back here I can hit? I think I missed a few flowers that I could do the force on. I can't break these, can I? No, okay. Sometimes you can break the flowers, sometimes you can't, so... Oh, and a heart too. Definitely grab that. Yeah, I missed a lot of flowers here. I guess that was a little more necessary than I thought they'd be. So let's just try to rectify that. Kind of break this, like, bike part. I wonder if I can do that. No, okay, nothing. It's as useless as it looks. Yeah, it's definitely looking like 40,000 is the number I need here. Oh, shit. Okay. Definitely try not to die. Nothing. Nice, I'll take that, though. Oh, I can destroy these. Wow, I can't believe I missed that. Damn. Oh, there's a hole here. How did I never see this? Oh, that's because you can't go down it. Just clear those guys out. Okay. Alright, I should be able to destroy these, and that should hopefully be enough? Maybe? I don't know. Oh, that's an odd visual bug. That's why I couldn't go down it, because it technically was covered up. Oh yeah, and that minikit there that I couldn't grab before. Now we can go down the hole and collect another minikit. Yeah, let's just get rid of him, because he could probably still shoot me. That would suck. Okay, so it wasn't 40,000, so maybe it's like 43, 44. It's always kind of like a round number, like a solid thousand, but sometimes it can be a weird solid thousand. I'm not taking any chances. If I see when I'm dispatching it, because this is starting to get stupid. Oh, whoops, wrong button. Shit. Okay, pick those up, please. Give me that heart. Good. There's gotta be something I missed here. This tree? Can I destroy the tree? I can. Okay, there's why. That's why I missed it. There it is. True Jedi. Alright, I'll see you guys back at the end of the stage, because that was ridiculous. Okay, there we are. So we got True Jedi. Now we can go and see what kind of plan Jar Jar has for us. Now that we finally got that meter. Alright, let's walk into the water and see what happens. I think he just dove into the ground. Not too sure. Could be wrong. That looked pretty shallow. Not gonna lie. Yeah, they ain't having any of that. Oh, but, you know, a little force magic goes a long way sometimes. Now we must travel through the planet core. But it's not a stage, so not really a lot to see there. If we don't have, like, a million studs by the time story mode is complete, then I'll be very surprised. I'm expecting, like, 2 million just from collecting True Jedi alone during the story.